So reduce initial server response time is one of the biggest painful thing you will see when you test your website with Google PageSpeed inside. And as per Google standard, if your website initial server response time is more than 600 milliseconds, this audit will fail and you will see this warning, reduce initial server response times. On my website, my initial server response time is just 30 milliseconds. Not just this, I'm able to achieve 97, sometime 100 out of 100 for mobile and 100 out of 100. Okay, so let's quickly see what is initial server response time. So when somebody open your website in their browser, it sends a request to the server. And server performs a lot of complex operations like fetching data from the database, organizing all the CSS, all JavaScript files, images, tags, and send back that response in HTML form. So the time between this request and this response is initial server response time. The lower it is, the faster your website will. And now we know what is server response time. Let me show you how we can reduce server response times once you like the video and subscribe to my channel. Because guys, it takes a lot of effort to create these videos. And if you like the video and subscribe to the channel, it will make me really happy. And I will know that you guys are enjoying my useful videos. So don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel. I really appreciate that. Okay, the first thing, if you're using WordPress, then use a cache plugin. Because when you use cache, the WordPress already got HTML pages saved on the server and they're directly served to users instead of processing all the PHP code, database operation and other things. And caching got two important parts. First is page caching, second database caching. If you want to see the effective video on caching, that how I got 100 out of 100 score for Google PageSpeed Insight, check out the card on the top or description of this video. The second thing, optimize the database. Delete unused tables, don't keep the old post revisions. Check my detailed video on optimizing database in the description or on the card on the top. The third and most important thing is use a good hosting. Guys, cheap hosting and a good hosting do not have so much difference. Maybe like in difference of $1 per month, you can have a really good hosting. I really recommend using Lightspeed hosting, which is really fast. If you want to know what hosting I use and my recommendation on fast and not expensive hosting, check the description of the video. The fourth thing, choose your theme carefully if you're using WordPress. A huge big theme is not always the time you need. Choose a lightweight theme. If you want to know my recommendation, I'll add some free themes and some premium themes in the description of the video, which are lightweight and which will not make your website slower. Fifth thing, do not use so many plugins. For every small thing, you do not need to install plugins. The more plugin you use, the more complex your website will be. It will take more time. And there are some faulty plugins which make your website slower. I created a video about it, how you can identify the slow plugins on your website. Check out the card on the top or description of the video so you can know what plugins are making your website slow exactly and you can replace them with good ones. Six things, guys, use a CDN. You can use a free CDN like Cloudflare and to really take the load off from your website by serving images, JavaScript, CSS files from their global servers. This is a small video, but if you really implement all these six things seriously, your website's initial server response time will really improve and your website will load really fast and you'll pass the audit for Google PageSpeed Insight. I already created a video about all these 6 points. You can check the description so you can implement those techniques and make your website's initial server response times very good, like my website, like 30 ms. I'm not guaranteeing you it's gonna be 30 ms, but yeah, it will be really improved and you'll pass this error for Google PageSpeed Insight test. And guys, like always, don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel. I really appreciate that. It gives me a message that you guys are appreciating my videos and my efforts. Thank you so much. See you in another video.